all good here. Before we begin, I just like skills rediscovery, because skills rediscovery is an edtech which offers courses in a lot of domains like business, creativity, lifestyle, technology. The main thing is that all these courses are live courses, so they are conducted in this way. So it's over a video call, so learners can learn right from their trainers in front of them. And also we have the option of doing the courses in multiple languages. So to hai hi, Hindi to hai hi, lekin saath mein Marathi, Kannada, Punjabi, Gujarati, all are beautiful languages of our country. We have trainers from all across the country. तो अलग अपनी पसंद की भाषा में अपने पसंद के ट्रेनर के साथ अपने पसंद के टाइमिंग के साथ, क्योंकि हर ट्रेनर का टाइमिंग अलग अलग होता है, तो कोर्सेज लिए जा सकते हैं। बाय द वे यश सिरोही जो है उनका भी कोर्स है, उसको भी लोग चाहें वो चेकआउट कर सकते हैं। टू बिगिन टुडेज सेशन आई वुड इन्वाइट मिस रुजुता फ्रॉम सिंपली बॉडी टॉक टू टॉक अबाउट व्हाट हर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डज।
Thank you so much. Yash, can you share a team? Thank you so much. So, now let me talk a little about Simply Body Talk. So, at Simply Body Talk, we specialize in the niche segment of non-verbal communication. And over the years, we have created a name for ourselves in the international space. Our clients are middle and senior level managers of some well-known international organizations, and our services include open format events, online coaching, and coaching programs. So these are some of our clients. So we have worked with Google, Adani, and there are a lot of other companies as well. So now let me tell you a little bit about Yash Sirohi. So our speaker for today is Yash, and he is an associate consultant at Simply Body Talk. So he has done his education in psychology, and with the background in psychology and body language training, he works for the online coaching programs of Simply Body Talk, and he also does the research for our coaching program. Okay, now let me tell you a little bit about our agenda for today. What are the things that we are going to do? So first, there is going to be a concept quiz. So there are going to be two quizzes, a concept quiz and a Mythbuster quiz. And we have some amazing prizes for these quizzes. So stay tuned for that. And then Yash will discuss a case study in which you can understand the importance of body language in interviews. And then I'll tell you a little bit about our online coaching, about our coaching program. And then I'll tell you, and then I'll announce the prizes of both these quizzes. And the prizes are amazing, so stay tuned for them. Oh, Yash, back to you.
So before we move ahead with the quiz, I just want to tell you that at the end of the session, we are going to be helping you. If you enjoy the session, if you find it interesting, and you want to know more about body language and how can you use it, we'll be at the end of the session. We're going to tell you about a few things that you can do and how can you enroll for any further session that you would like to come. Now we're going to start with a quiz time. I would want all of you to at least keep your videos on so that we all can see each other. Okay. If you can keep your videos on, that would be really great. So I'll give you a few minutes to just keep it, turn on the videos.
And I'm also going to keep a record of who is being more interactive and participative. So I'm taking a note of that, just letting you know. And there are great prizes at the end.
So anybody who wants to turn their video on, come on guys. So we're going to start with this quiz. In this quiz, what we're going to do is basically you have to type down the answers in the chat box, okay, of different things that will be asked. Do not Google it. It gets very obvious if you Google something and type the answers. Make sure that you write down the answers as quickly as possible. Now we'll start with the first quiz, that is a close-ended question. What do you think is a close-ended question when it comes to interviews? or in general also. Do you know what's closed-ended questions? You can type your answers in the chat. Anyone, what are closed-ended questions? Come on, you can type it in the chat. This is a small quiz. You have to do it as quickly as possible. The winners will get a prize worth 5,000 rupees. So come on. Anyone? Do you guys know what is closed-ended question? Do you know what is open-ended question? Do you know what are closed-ended questions? Anyone? You can unmute yourself and also speak if you are confused about what to type. Hi, hello guys, are you there? Where the question has a specific answer? Yeah, a lot of times questions have a specific answer, but you're very close, but try to think more about it. What is a closed-ended question? You can unmute yourself and also speak. If you feel ki type karne mein there is some confusion, ki kya type karenge, you can unmute yourself and speak.
Sir, closed-ended question means in which we have to give choose one response. Any response we have to choose, like we have some options in front of
us. Right. Okay. What else? Audrey? So you guys are very close. Closed-ended questions are the type of questions which have a very limited type of answers. Usually these are yes or no questions. Lot of times interviewers are going to ask you a closed-ended question, and it's really important for you all to know how to answer that. A closed-ended question is always usually asked by the interviewer to make the interview quick or to make the things flow more quickly. So what they do is, if you have an answer which is elaborate than yes or no, or you want to add a bit more detail, first start with replying with a yes or no. So if let's say they tell you something, do you have experience in so and so thing? So you say yes, but or yes, I have a very specific experience in this. Whatever you want to add, you start with the first yes or no. Don't just start with a very big sentence and then just continue. Even the interviewer is not going to lose interest, and you're not going to appear very much sure about yourself. So you can start with yes or no, whatever your answer is, and then go into detail. Don't go in before. Next one is the STAR technique. Who knows STAR technique? Kisi ko pata hai STAR technique kya hai? STAR technique mein kya hota hai? Kya hai STAR technique? नहीं भी पता है तो नो भी टाइप कर सकते हो चार स्टार टेक्निक क्या है नो ओके तो दो जन को ही नहीं पता है बाकी सबको पता है स्टार टेक्निक क्या स्टार टेक्निक इज सिचुएशन task, action, result. Okay. Whenever you are in any interview, if you've been asked a specific question, or you've been asked a specific skill that you have, or how did you tackle something, first you explain the situation, then explain what was your task, then what action did you took, and then what was the result by that action. Now, why this is important to go in this format is whenever you face any issues, rather than saying or boasting about ki I am very hardworking, I am a problem solver, you telling a specific situation is going to make your skill more authentic, and the interviewer is also going to be able to understand what all skills or set of skills that you have. So it's really important to try to implement the STAR technique in this. Next is leading an interview. What do you think you mean by leading an interview? How do you lead an interview? Anyone? What is the meaning of leading an interview? Have you ever heard the word leading an interview? You can unmute and also speak. giving best answers to impress the interviewer. Okay. Anyone, what do you mean by leading an interview? Anyone wants to give an answer? Only Nikhil is getting applicants to answer your questions instead of letting them tell you what they want to know. Okay. But you are the interviewee, so how will you lead an interview? How will you get the application to answer your questions? You're not the interviewer, right? You're the interviewee. Letting them know about you more clearly. Okay, very good. So basically, whenever you are, how do you lead an interview? You lead an interview by preparing a basic introduction about yourself, which includes hints of a lot of things that you have been involved in. So let's say if you work in an organization where you work in the marketing department, you also have experience with the accounting department, you have also worked with the finance department also, and you're working with these three departments simultaneously, you are the person who is in the link. So in an introduction, you try to hint all of these things that you have done. What is that going to do? It is going to create more curiosity for the interviewer to ask you questions on these topics, so that you know what all things the interviewer is going to ask. That is how you will lead the interview. It is really important to hint the interviewer about the things that you are aware of or what is in your experience, so that they ask you question based on the things that you are good at and which you hinted them to. Next is core competency. What are core competencies? Anyone? Core competencies. What if somebody asked you in an interview, what are your core competencies? What are they? What are core competencies, guys?
Escape areas.
Can you repeat? Shabir?
Yes, sir. Skills areas.
Skills areas. Yes. Very good. So skills ka area bahut important ho jata hai. Aur kya? कोर कॉम्पिटेंसीज किस चीज को बोलेंगे? यू आर वेरी कॉम्पिटेंट इन दिस. कोर कॉम्पिटेंसीज आर बेसिकली योर स्किल्स दैट यू व्हेन हैव समबडी आस्क यू व्हाई व्हाट आर द स्किल्स दैट यू हैव यू लॉट ऑफ हैव यू माइट हैव हर्ड इन लॉट ऑफ इंटरव्यूज. समबडी सेज आई एम हार्ड वर्किंग, आई एम a problem solver, I am a team player, and those things like that, right? So those are sort of your core competencies, or even if you have an expertise in some subject, that will also come as a core competency. Now the question is, if somebody tells you that they're hardworking or they are a team player, it sounds very, very rehearsed, right? It doesn't make you feel authentic. And how do you know that the person is hardworking? How do you know that they are a team player? You can't know that, right? So how do you tell your core competencies? You use whatever your core competencies are, you prepare them. These are the skill set, or these are the things which I'm very competent about, or I'm very capable in these categories. And then you think about an example. Where did I learn these things? And then when you are talking about your core competencies, what time do you speak about these competencies with the example? कि कोई भी चीज बोलोगे कि मैं मेरे ये अच्छा है, मुझे ये आता है, तो उसके साथ उसका एक example तुम्हारे पास होना चाहिए जहाँ पर तुमने वो चीज use की थी. Next is first impression. अभी मुझे बताओ कि first impression में क्या क्या चीजें आती हैं. planning and plotting. First impression, confidence. Confidence mein kya hota hai? Confidence kaise dikhta hai? Body language, looks. Aur kya? We have 25 people and only 3-4 log answer kar rahe. Come on. First impression ke bare mein I think sabko pata hoga. Well dressed, eye contact, very good. Look, speech should be elegant, okay. Dressing up. Aur kya hota? Aur kya hota? Ability to listen others, okay. Wo first impression mein nahi aayega particularly. इंटरक्शन ड्रेस अप बिहेवियर ओके कोई हाइजीन नहीं बोल रहा है नाखून नाखून काट के जाना चाहिए हमें इंटरव्यू में कि नहीं और क्या फर्स्ट इंप्रेशन में द वे यू वॉक इनटू द इंटरव्यू रूम वो आएगा कि नहीं आएगा Grooming, very good. Your voice. What else? Punctuality, very good. That is also something which comes the way he or she carries himself. Very good. So, first impressions start right from the moment you enter the cabin. So, the way you are walking in, the way you are greeting, those also the other things which come under the first impression, not just how you are prepared for that interview, but the moment you enter, the moment they can see you, that is when you start to make a first impression. If somebody tells you to sit and then you will make a first impression, that is not true. The moment you open the door and the moment the interviewers can see you, you make a first impression. And for a lot of interviews, there are very high stake interviews, how you are sitting in the waiting area, how you are interacting with the people in the waiting area, those things are also impacted. So right from the moment that interviewers can see you, you are making your first impression. It is very important for you to make sure that I don't think about that this is how things I want to do. If I settle down that, then they'll make a first impression. That's not true. The moment they see you, they are making your first impression, and it takes less than 60 seconds to make a first impression. So I want you guys to be very quick on your feet. Now, where does body language come into this? Okay, how can body language help you in an interview? So in an interview, in any interview, body language is going to be important for impressing the interviewer, making sure that you appear very confident, very, very impressive, very passionate about whatever you are speaking. That is where everybody thinks ki interview ka importance hai. Ki yehi ek jagah pe body language use hoti hai interviews mein. Ki how impressive, how confident that you look. That is the only place where the body language comes. But that is not true. Body language is very important to project confidence. Now, projection of confidence is not just ki how confident you look in the beginning. It's all how confident are you about each section that or each type of portion, about your academics, or about your ability to do the work for them or solve the problem for this organization. It is really important for you to project that confidence. Just by sitting a certain way or keeping your body a certain way, you won't be able to. You need to tweak your body or look more confident in different situations for the interview to project that confidence or self-confidence that is should be visible to the interviewer in any scenario. Let it be your academics when they're talking about, let it be your experience, let it be your skills. It's really important for you to keep this confidence throughout the whole situation. Next is building a connect. Now, if you can understand what the interviewer is liking, what are the sort of things that the interviewer is interested about, then you can build a connection with the interviewer. Nobody talks about that. You need to also understand the interviewer, what they are looking for, what are the things that they are interested in. That is really important. So body language allows you to build a connect with the interviewer so that you can customize your answers accordingly. Next is communicating passion. Nowadays, a lot of people are not focusing on what kind of experience you have, or those things are important, but those are not as important. A lot of organizations, and even our organization, tends to sometimes, if we have equally qualified candidates, if somebody even slightly less qualified or has some less marks or something like that, but the amount of passion that the person might be having for the work which we are hiring them for can be something which can turn the decision around. Organizations prefer to hire someone who is very passionate about their work, and it is really important for you to look confident but also convey how passionate you are about whatever topic you're talking about or whatever interview that you're giving. Passion can allow the interviewer to also make things, can hire you, because a lot of time passionate employees can grow skills, develop things very quickly. So it's very important for you to communicate how passionate you are. Next is tackling difficult situations. Everybody goes in an interview, okay, I'll do this, I'll do that, I'll do this, I'll speak this, these things, and that is how much they prepare for an interview. But a lot of times people don't think about how to answer the question which is being asked to you. It's really important for you to have a certain technique and the ways to answer these questions, and also appear and be that much confident while tackling these difficult questions. A lot of times stress interviews are there. How do you keep yourself calm and appear more confident when you're extremely stressed, you're sweating? How do you do that? And the next thing is standing out. If you are able to do all these five things, you're going to be a candidate who stands out in front of the interview. It is really important for you to combine all of these things. It's really important for you to project your passion, building a connection with the interviewer, being able to answer the question with the same confidence that you enter with, and the impressing the interviewer is something which you all hear about. Now, what we're going to do is I'm going to show you a simple interview. It's a basic TV interview, but I want you to tell me, what can you see in this interview? Okay, what do you think is happening? You can unmute yourself and speak anything. Ye interview mein kya sahi ho raha hai, kya galat ho raha hai. Okay?
Yes, I think the audio is not very clear. Guys, can you please tell us? Are you able to hear nicely?
Share the computer. I'll optimize it for clip if let's see. You can hear it better. Is it better?
Not quite. Yes.
Whatever the speaking is, the part is not the focus. You just have to look what's happening. Even if you can understand half of the audio, it's completely fine. But you have to observe how these two people are interacting. What are this? Do you think that they are getting bonded together? Do you think they are giving each other the enough attention that is required in an interview? Do you think they are looking confident in this situation? You have to look all of those things in their behavior.
So to help me with that, please welcome my friend, neighbor, and flag virgin, yet not a real virgin, Penny.
Hello.
So Penny, I understand you would like to learn more about flags.
Yeah, I can't tell you how many times I've been at a party where everyone's talking about flags and I just couldn't join in.
Well, you came to the right place.
I'm sorry, can we just pause for a minute?
Okay. Anyone, what did you observe in this video? Do you think they are bonding? Do you think they are looking confident? Do you think there is any connect with them? No audio. Fun with flags. Can you hear it now? Fun with flags is not just for the flag aficionado. Did anybody notice anything about their behavior, anything about their body language?
Sir, it's body language is very low confidence. His body.
How do you think? Why do you think Shabir is low confidence? Or kiska? The ladka jo bol raha hai ya ladki jo bol
rahi hai? Sir, the boy. Because
Kyun?
The way he is sitting.
बैठने में क्या है उसका? सही जा रहे हो, बराबर बोल रहे हो. But थोड़ा सा और उसको we'll break it down.
His body posture is like little bit banded type.
Okay. The boy
and
looks nervous.
Not, facing front.
He's not facing?
Front means he is sitting a little bit tilted. So this also signifies. Low confident body language.
Okay. Priyanka is saying body, boy looks nervous, sitting posture is not proper, not confident too. Okay. I understand that he's not confident, but I want you guys to break down why do you think he doesn't look confident? Anything other than his sitting posture. You are absolutely right. Yeah, there is something about his sitting posture. He's an introvert. Okay. Greeting, welcoming is not so good. Body posture, eye interaction is not there. Very good. He is not the person who is coming for an interview or is also coming at the interview. He is not looking at in not looking into the camera and also not looking at the person who is there. So there is, and the other thing which we'll see is very good. I'll show you a few things. Okay, here is it. Now when we look at this, we can see that first and foremost thing is sitting. Has it ever happened that you have, you can type it in the chat, how many of you have gone for an interview before and how many of you not gone. So you can just type yes if you have gone for an interview before, or you can type no if you have never gone for an interview. An offline interview. So Nikhil has gone for an interview. Priyanka has also gone. Okay. No. Okay. Very good. So has it ever happened that you enter the interview cabin or the room and you sit on the chair, but you don't sit properly on the chair? You sit on the edge of the chair. Has it ever happened with you? Sorry, Chetan. Hello.
Yeah, I think that was by mistake. Yeah.
Okay. So has it ever happened that you have not seated comfortably in the chair and you end up sitting on the bilkul corner of the chair? That is something which happened. No, never happened to me. Okay. Very good, Nikhil. There's a lot of times when people are nervous, they come to sit on the chair and they sit on the corner of the chair or the bilkul edge of the chair. And then the whole interview, they stay very nervous, confused about what to do, and they cannot settle down. Same thing is happening over here. He has yes with me. Perfect. So a lot of times people are, they do not settle down in the chair or the place where they're sitting. First thing that is happening in this picture is he is sitting on the corner, not at all feeling comfortable in the situation. Next thing is when the other person also arrives, even if this person was in an interview, he is not looking at the person or the camera, as both of you, all of you pointed out. That if the camera was your audience or the interviewer, he is not looking at the camera. If the lady or the girl who was the person who he wanted to connect with, he is not looking or talking to her. So it's really important for your body and your face and eye contact to be towards the person you want to talk to. Otherwise, you won't be able to connect with them. Next is an introduction. The introduction was very haphazard. There was no greeting for the person who arrived. There was no handshake for the person who arrived. There was no introduction about himself and also for the person. It's really important for you to keep your attention from. Next is the attention part of it. The lady is trying to seek an attention, but the other person is neither turning his body away or towards the person. So it is very important for you to give the attention to the door. Of time, you're going to find 3-4 people who are sitting in front of you for an interview. And in this situation, you cannot just watch one person or cannot just look up, down, niche, upper, neck. You need to give attention to all of the interviewers. It is really, really important.
James, I've read your
CV. So now we'll look at a one case study. Okay. What I want you guys to do in this is, I want you guys to let me know first whether you can hear the audio or not. And then I want you to tell me what is happening in this interview.
James, I've read your CV and personal statements, and it's fair to say that they are exceptional. Exceptionally bad, that is.
I'm happy to explain my CV to you. I've never had any major issues with it before, so I'll...
Well, it's all gibberish to me. Just gibberish. And
okay, Claude,
hang on a second, I'm finished. I gather that you work in the telecoms industry.
Yes.
How does an ordinary employer who's not in this industry know what rate-busting NGN is? How am I supposed to guess whether that's something that's worthy and very... Oh, God, my goodness me. You produced a business plan for rate-buster NGN. I mean, it's full of rubbish.
There are, to be honest with you, my CV is very specific to the telecoms industry. Exactly. I went through it, and I'd like you to say that 90% of that CV is readable. There is, granted,
90% of it is unreadable, in my view. I don't understand it. You did SLA testing. Well, I don't know whether...
Well, service
SLA
level agreement is a fairly well-known... I actually remember reading that and thinking that most folk... Well,
an OTR003, DP, and... I mean...
That's with regard to a
but
specific...
But I don't care.
What is happening in this? Anyone? What do you see happening in this interview? He's very rude. Who's very rude? The interviewee or the interviewer? Person taking the interview or the person who is giving the interview? Who is rude? Anyone else? Come on. What is happening? What did you see in this interview?
Are you continuously arguing with the interviewer?
Very good. He's constantly arguing with the interviewer. Very good. What else? Or kya dekha? Forget even what is right, what is wrong. Kya dekha? Kya dekha? The guy is also not confident with his vocal, and he is a lot hesitant. Okay. He looks very hesitant.
He is interrupting the interviewer while you asking questions.
हाँ तो इंटरव्यूअर को इंटरप्ट कर रहा है आस्क क्वेश्चन था पूछ के ओके और उसको कैसे स्ट्रेस फील हो रहा है कैसे वो डर रहा है हेजिटेशन हो रहा है वो कुछ दिखा ऐसे कौन कि कहाँ पर उसका कॉन्फिडेंस डगमगा रहा है कैसे पता चल रहा है हमें कि उसका कॉन्फिडेंस कम हो गया है इट टर्न्स इनटू एन आर्ग्यूमेंट फ्रॉम एन इंटरव्यू वेरी गुड बट वो आर्ग्यूमेंट बदल जाता है बट लेकिन देखा क्या कि इंटरव्यूअर्स आपको समझा कि कब इंटरव्यूअर ने अनॉय होके छोड़ दिया कि अब इसको नहीं हायर करना है Anyone else? When he disagrees with the interviewer. Okay, I'll show you. First thing is fear. Okay. It is very, the question difficulty raised he lost. Okay. Okay. We know that this is a very extreme scenario, just where the interviewer is so brutal and then he's being so rude to the interviewee. That doesn't happen very normally. It is a very rare case scenario. But it does happen if an interviewer is not having a day, but it's usually something which happens where is not very likely to happen. But something which is very, very important for you to understand is how the interviewee was communicating his body language toward this person. First thing which we saw on his face was the fear. A lot of times interviewers might not be able to identify these different things, but it will make them constantly react in a certain manner, which might not work in the favor. So first thing that we saw when the question came up about the resume or the CV, the person showed fear. The next thing which happened in that particular thing is the discomfort. After knowing that okay, something is wrong with an interview a CV and things are not working in his favor, he started to purse his lips like this. When he started to feel a lot of discomfort, he usually look with the stress because the lips tight karte hain, pasina aata hai, muh pochte hain, things like that. So first, what he is doing is pursing his lips. Next thing is, that's the discussion or the argument which you all told, it changed into an argument that went on. Did somebody notice ki usne apne haath kidhar rakhe? उसने उसके हाथ उसके पैरों के बीच में दबा दिए। अब now you might, it might not have been very evidently visible to you, but interviewer के सामने ही दिखता कि now you're putting your hands between your legs, okay, which is not a very way, in a way that you portray that you are very confident or you are open to explaining or you are basically you'll be able to explain whatever the interviewer is asking. That is something which is not working in his favor. So he closes up his body language. Next is a displeasure. The interviewee shows a small grin on his face. He's like, now I know what I have written is right. That is something which is also not advised for you to do. Now, why I'm telling you these things, okay? The interviewer anyways was going to not take him because it got very, very rude. And but a lot of times, interviewers purposely make a stressful situation to see how do you handle that stressful situation. And it's really important for you to keep yourself together and convey that confidence in those stressful situations. It's really important for all of you to understand ki how do you show these emotions, fear, stress, discomfort. That is why I'm showing how did this person show. So you can think about and introspect how did you show. Now we come to the interviewer's side. Okay. When you see, look at these two pictures, okay. In one picture, the interviewer is looking at the papers, okay? He's pointing at something. Now, this is a state where the interviewer is confused or could be irritated. So, you can ask, offer your help as an interviewee. That is, if there is any confusion in my CV or if there is any doubts that you have, you can I'd be happy to explain it to you. Now, in the other picture, you see he is doing this, the same thing the interviewee was doing, the displeasure, which is very evident on the interview. So that is where you have lost the interviewer. Then at this point, there is no point in arguing about the same thing with the interviewer. It is best that you say, apologize for it, or you say that, okay, I'm sorry, you will make sure that I improve, or you offer your help. Is there anything I can do to explain to you? There is no point in constantly arguing with the interviewer at this point. It's really important for you to also understand what interviewer is feeling at what point. Okay, now I'm going to bust some myths for you guys. For this activity, I want you to be very interactive, okay? I want you guys to give answers more quickly. Now, what is going to happen is I'm going to show you two images, okay? One image at a time. What I want you to do is I want you to observe this image and tell me what do you think is working in this image and what do you think is not working in this image. Okay, kuch bhi ho sakta hai, kuch acha ho sakta hai image mein jo acha ho raha hai, kuch acha nahi ho raha ho sakta hai, kuch bhi hoga, jo bhi aapko lagta hai aap chart mein niche likh lijiye. This is the first image. Isme kya acha ho raha hai aur kya bura ho raha hai aur kya lagta hai ya kuch bhi acha kuch bhi bura nahi ho raha. No eye contact, okay. Why do you think there is no eye contact?
Properly.
Yeah?
सर हैंडशेक प्रॉपरली नहीं कर रहे बस
वेरी गुड हैंडशेक बराबर नहीं है वेरी गुड हैंडशेक बराबर नहीं है इसमें नो गुड स्माइल कॉन्फिडेंट लुक्स इंटरैक्टिव ओके Body language is confident, positive smile. Okay, so one thing which is happening good in this image is that they're at least looking at each other. You might have noticed that you don't maintain eye contact. You forget what did you saw when you were shaking hands or greeting this person. It is really important for you to look at the person while you greet them and also maintain an eye contact while you're greeting. So that is one thing which is happening good, but the handshake in this image is not proper. Whenever you're shaking hands with anyone, make sure that there is a proper palm-to-palm contact with the other person.